Your greatest blessings are going to be channeled through the partnership with the person that God has for you. And it's worth the wait, because if you don't wait until you're ready, you're going to...
Just wait.
You're going to get divorced. You're going to get divorced.
Just wait.
It's just going to be a lot of pain and anguish that you didn't have to go through had you just waited.
P-Pod, it's your girl, Key.
And I'm Sean P, the leader and general of the illest team known to man, the Purefoys, a.k.a.
Your family's favorite family.
Today is day 17 of our Daniel fast. We are just four more days and then it's over. But we've been studying this amazing devotion by Scott Williams called Fast Like Daniel. And we've been using the lessons that we're learning in this devotion to strengthen our marriage.
More than anything, we want to help our community build lifelong lasting marriages filled with love and happiness. But before we get into today's marriage question answered, please hit that like button and don't forget to subscribe to our channel. And make sure you click that notification bell so you don't miss anything that goes on with the Purefoys.
In our last video, we talked about how marriages are strengthened by setting expectations and aligning your mindset with your actions so that things can get accomplished. But today's question is,
when should I get married?
Just because God tells us that he's going to do something doesn't necessarily mean that he's going to do it right away. Sometimes it takes a week, a month, a year, but it's all in God's timing. Sometimes God shows us things before they happen because he wants us to prepare ourselves before the blessing comes. And because God is a God of order, other things that are out of our control have to happen before the promise is fulfilled. In the meantime, while we're just waiting for God's blessings to come to fruition, we need to maintain our faith and know that God will come through for us just like he said he would. We don't have to force the issue or try to take matters into our own hands, because when we do that, we wind up making things worse than they already are.
Like the devotion today said, God's timing is not our own timing. Yesterday, I spoke of me always wanting to get married and have children. But instead of waiting for God the first time, I decided to take matters into my own hands, which ended up causing me nothing but pain, like Sean just said, like you turn out worse, you know? So I just wanna encourage you to stay the course, stay expectant, and see what God can do in your life.
You will know when it's time to get married because you've prepared for it. You don't have to be perfect or have all your ducks in a row, but your heart has to be positioned towards the things of marriage. And like we said in the last video, your mindset and your actions will have aligned themselves together so that you can do the things that marriage requires.
There is an entire process that comes with being married. Mm-hmm. For instance, you have to be loving, selfless, kind, patient, have self-control, be slow to speak so that you don't hurt your spouse's feelings. The list goes on and on. Not saying that you have to be perfect, but those are some of the things that you have to incorporate into your marriage.
Yeah, and I think about even our own story. God showed me you when we were in high school, but I wasn't ready for what? I wasn't ready for that type of relationship at that time. And I don't think either one of us was, you know, because you weren't patient and I wasn't faithful or even trying to be committed yet, and ended up working in our favor because later on, after we've acquired these things that we would need to love and nurture one another, that's when we were both ready to be married. We knew what we wanted, and I believe that we were prepared to do those things. I was prepared to be a husband that the faithful person and the loving person that you would need, and you would be the patient person. You would be the
slow to speak, because I was never slow to speak. That came, the patience came, you know, and it's a process. That's why I say it's an entire journey. Yeah. But you know, you practice, and God won't give you your spouse until you know how to do those things, so that you know how to handle a relationship.
So what can our subscribers, the people who are following this journey, what can they do to make sure that they are ready for marriage?
First things first, they can use the other relationships that they have, whether they're with their family or their friends, to just take the time and use those fruits of the Spirit that, you know, were mentioned earlier, and just to practice them.
Like you've been saying, you have to build that muscle memory. Marriage is a partnership, and sometimes it's not an equal partnership. Mm-hmm. Sometimes you're doing more than what the other person is doing, but because you love them and you're willing to stay the course and you're willing to sacrifice, you don't get bent out of shape because things don't seem even.
There's never even, guys.
Right. There's a lot of times it's, you know, 95-5. Mm-hmm. Seldomly is it 50-50.
Yeah.
When it gets there, it's really sweet, mm-hmm. but there's usually someone doing a little bit more at a certain point in the marriage. Mm-hmm. Your greatest blessings are going to be channeled through the partnership with the person that God has for you. Mm. And it's worth the wait, because if you don't wait until you're ready, you're going to...
Just wait.
You're going to get divorced. You're going to get divorced.
Just wait.
It's just going to be a lot of pain and anguish that mm-hmm. you didn't have to go through had you just waited. Mm-hmm. All right, that's it for today's devotion and marriage question answered. Thanks to everyone who has been checking in and engaging with this content.
If you haven't already, friend us on the Bible app so we can connect with you, not just on YouTube, but in God's Word as well.
We will catch you in the next one, but until then, live, let love.
Peace.